Hello, I'm Gavin Hoey and you're watching another Photoshop tutorial. This week we're going to do a little bit of portrait work because I'm going to show you how to take an outdoor picture and turn it into a stunning studio style portrait. Now first of all I need to thank Dave Cross for the use of the picture. Now the picture came from his website, which is davecross.blogspot.com, and it's one of the websites I tend to visit fairly frequently because it's got a whole bunch of different Photoshop tips, tricks, techniques, and it's a really good read, so well worth checking out. Let's have a look at the technique. So here's the picture that we're going to use. As you can see, it's a nice outdoors portrait. It's got a few things I want to change, so I'm going to start off by getting the crop tool and just making a crop of the picture, because although this is okay, I personally prefer a bit of a tighter crop. I'm also going to give it a bit of a rotate as well. Let's just turn it slightly that way. The crop I'm going to go for is one that comes down, really just takes the top of the hair off like that, and we'll bring it in slightly. It's maybe a little bit too much. Let's just bring it across like that and takes it down to the wrist area like so. Click the tick to rotate the image and crop it at the same time. Okay, so that's looking better straight away, but there's a few areas that we'd like to address, particularly on the skin tones. Now, to be honest, the little lady here has got lovely skin tones, really, really nice. But there's a few areas that we could just change a little bit. So there's a bit here. I'm going to get myself the healing brush tool and select an area that's pretty much perfect and just heal it over the top of those parts like that. There we go. Little bit down here as well. Let's do that better, shall we? That's better. And some more on her cheek, so we'll just do a few little spots here. Now you could use the spot healing brush, that also works, but for me the healing brush itself has a little bit more control, so I can get exactly the areas I want. I can take away those little fine bits of hair like that, you see. Lovely, and a bit of a tidy up. But it's kind of this line here that really worries me more, and the shadow underneath the eyes here. It looks like we've got some shadows coming off of the hair, but we can use the healing brush to sort those areas too. Get a nice big brush, select an unblemished area of skin, and just paint across that area there. Now the nice big brush will heal and cover and join like that, so you can't actually see that line, it blends it out. These are a little bit smaller and I don't have so much room to play with, so I'm going to shrink my brush back down again. But again, select an unblemished area of skin, and we'll just paint it over the top like that. Now this always looks absolutely rubbish, right up until the point where you let go of the mouse, and then hey presto, it all gets really, really good. So that's the beauty of the healing brush. Okay, so there we are. We've now sorted out the skin tones a little bit, but we're going to give this picture the sort of skin tones that you might find in glossy magazines. We're going to give it that super smooth skin tone effect. And we're going to do it by applying two blur filters. Let's have a look. First of all, I'm going to make a copy layer, duplicate layer, so I've got an exact copy of the image. And on that layer, I'm going to apply the first filter. Filter, blur, and surface blur. Now this is the standard blur filter I use whenever I'm trying to smooth off skin tones. And I'm going to drop the radius down to 5 and the threshold to 10. I don't really want it doing too much work. But this image is quite a low resolution picture, so in fact it really does kind of blur more or less everything. But we're going to show you how to get that detail back where you want it. It involves just putting a layer mask on there, getting a nice close-up view of what you're doing, and grabbing yourself the paintbrush. And with a black paintbrush, I'm just going to paint black onto the eye just to bring the detail back, and onto the eyebrow as well. And the other side will do that too. So areas like the lips here where we've just lost the detail by applying the surface blur, we're going to recover the detail by masking it away. Now the big area that I've lost is actually the detail in the hair. It's still sort of there, and on the video it probably looks fine, but trust me, it's not looking good. It's just gone a little bit too smooth, almost like it's been painted with a paintbrush rather than an actual photograph. So I'm just going to bring that back in by masking those areas too. Now when you're happy, you can merge those layers down, so layer and just flatten the image like that, and we're ready for the next step. It's another blur filter, so let's go back to layer, duplicate layer, and go back to filter, choose blur again, and this time we're going to use the classic, the good old classic Gaussian blur. Now that's a little bit too much blur. In fact, I can't actually see the picture anymore, so we're going to drop this down. Again, a low resolution image like this needs a radius of 5 to 10 probably, so we're going to go for around about 8. Oh, nearly had it, 7.8, that'll do just fine. Now I'm going to try and merge these two layers together somehow by changing the blend mode. Now currently it's set to normal, which means we can't see through the blurry layer. You could drop the opacity down, but a trick I like to do is to just switch from the normal blend mode to my favourite blend mode, overlay. And that'll give a lift in contrast and a boost in colour as well. Again, I'm going to flatten that down. I don't need the two layers. And we're back down to one. So we're given this some wonderfully smooth skin tones. But the next thing to sort out is the actual background. Now the background on this picture is what it was. It was as it was shot. But I want to take that background away and replace it with another. I could do that by making a selection, but selecting hair can be tricky. So I'm going to make my life a little bit easier. Rather than trying to remove the background, I'm just going to paint my own in. Because studio backgrounds are often white or black, and we're going to make a black one. So let's come down to our layers, make a new one, and we'll get a paintbrush, and make sure we've got black as our foreground colour, which we have, and we'll just paint black onto the picture like that. Okay, and then round the other side as well. Now, I know what you're thinking, it doesn't look that good at the moment. So what we're going to do is zoom out a little bit and get a bigger brush that's nice soft edges to it and just paint around the edge. And this will just feather in a little bit of darkness just onto the edges of the hair. Now, it does a couple of things. Firstly, it blends it into the background, but also it takes away some of those stray fine hairs and gives a much more neater look. Now whilst we're here, we might as well go around the wrists as well, because if I was shooting this picture in a studio environment, I'd think about lighting it carefully so I didn't have these areas as brightly lit as they are now, like that. Okay, let's flatten that down again, layer and flatten image. Speaking of darkening a few bits down, the hand here, now that is actually the brightest part of the picture. Now with portraits, what you want is the eyes really to be the dominant part of the picture. And your eyes will be drawn to whatever the lightest part of the picture is. So if the lightest part is the back of the hand, that's not going to work correctly. So we're going to darken it down by getting the burn tool. Make sure it's set to highlight. And we'll just darken those areas down just with a few clicks. Not a lot, just enough just to tone it in a little bit. Let's have a look at the levels, because looking at the picture as a whole, I'm thinking it now looks a little bit dark all over. So we'll pull up the levels, and yeah, looking at that histogram, you can see that histogram shows that this image is rather towards the dark side. Now don't be fooled, this picture has a lot of black in it, so you would expect the graph to be weighed towards the black end, but there's literally nothing in the white end at all, so this is a little underexposed. Just drag this in a little bit just to bump up the exposure like that. Okay, that's looking pretty good. I'm going to try and push this a little bit harder by putting an adjustment layer in. So let's open the adjustment layers and I'm going to put in good old brightness and contrast. We'll just bump up the contrast a little bit like that. And brightness, well, we could try tweaking it a little bit, but I think it's probably about right where it is. So we'll leave it more or less where it was. That's fine. So that's giving us a nice increase in contrast, but I have lost some of that hair detail. But every adjustment layer comes by default with its very own layer mask. So I can recover some of that hair detail by getting a paintbrush, getting one of a lower opacity brush, something like that, and just painting a bit of black, well, grey, I suppose, really, onto that layer mask. And where I paint, I just start to reveal a little bit of hair just coming back through like that. Okay, that's looking much better. Right, now, the final thing to do is a bit of dodging and burning. The picture is generally now completed, but there's a bit of tidying up to do. The eye is still a little bit dark, the hand is still a little bit light. So let's go back and work on the image itself, not the adjustment layer. And we'll grab ourselves, what have we got? Let's go with the dodge tool, first of all. Now, the dodge tool will bring out the tones from the shadows and reveal the darker areas. So with a slightly bigger brush, I'm just going to put that over the eye. Make sure we're working on shadows, which we are. That does help. And we can just dodge that eye, bring it back up and brighter, like so. And what else can we do here? Well, we can darken down that hand. It's still, although I darkened it earlier, still a little bit bright for me. So we'll just darken that down. Now, when you often burn in something like that, if it's already quite white and you darken it down, something that's white will darken as grey. Even with protect tones turned on, it doesn't always work. So I'm just going to change to the sponge tool, make sure I'm working on saturate, and just saturate the hands up a little bit. Now that'll just help to bring a bit of tone in there like that. And whilst I've got this tool in hand, I might as well do her eye as well. And we'll make sure that her eye's got a nice glowing colour to it, like so. Okay, so there we go. That's the whole technique completed. We now have super soft skin tones. We have studio-style lighting. And we've gone from the straight picture there through to our studio-engineered picture. Of course, the beauty with that picture is it was a pretty good image to start with, and that really helps. But it just goes to show that using Photoshop, you can lift an outdoor picture and give it that studio quality indoor lighting.